This video is made possible by Rangerrob poopy bags, available on Amazon right now. Hello everyone, this is Rangerrob and welcome to Rangerrob Country Living. I want to welcome you to the channel. Today is a kind of a cold, blustery day outside, so I decided to spend a little time talking about some of the things we've talked in the past about a little bit, which is, kind of getting on top of things. Now, let's see, where are we in October right now? We got elections coming up and things like that. So I don't want to talk about that part as much as no matter what happens, it appears that we're going to be having some issues like food shortages. And I don't think it's really that much politics as it is the COVID and trying to help companies are dealing with that. Whether they're going overboard or underboard, who knows? It's hard to say. So some of the things that I know that we're kind of doing to get ready for any inconvenience, let's just put it that way, is obviously building up our food. We'll be the first one to tell you we are weak at food preservation as far as canning. And yes, it's true. It's harder in heck to find jars. And so we've literally spent certain days where we've gone to 4 different stores trying to find jars. And we have been stumbling onto some. Actually, a unique place we got some that we're looking for the small 1 pint. We actually found them at Bed and Bath in Bend, Oregon. And but we go like to several places, Bi-Mart, Walmart, Wilco, and we did Bed and Bath the other day. We tried Target, and it's kind of hit and miss. Every once in a while you run into a couple, and then sometimes you don't get the right jars that you want. But we have been, and when we do buy any, we usually only buy 2 and not hoard them. And over time, we've actually built our numbers up, so we're pretty happy about that. One of the other things we did, I wasn't sure if I was overreacting or not, but we ordered a lot of seeds of things we want to grow for our spring garden. So we did mostly Baker Creek and then some True Leaf, and I think those are the 2 that I used. But we did build up our numbers really well in seeds. And I think I did a video in the past that showed you how we could put them in the containers and store them and categorize them. And Sherry and I will probably sit down, go through our inventory one more time to make sure we got everything we want for the spring. Or the one thing I want to do for the first time will be potatoes. And I'd love to hear in the comments below how you get your potato starters. I've actually heard that you could literally go to the grocery store, buy organic, since they haven't been treated, and actually use those for starters. Love to hear if people have been doing that. If not, where's a good place to get potato starters? The other thing we've been doing is like, just in case the banks are acting weird, and I'm not... It may not, whatever, but I highly recommend that you probably build up your cash a little bit. So we've definitely set aside amount of cash to just in case the ATMs are not working for a little while or something like that. Whether that's going to happen or not, that's not really something I want to predict. And the other thing we're doing is we've been buying silver. And not a lot, just here and there. And instead of buying like... Well, I bought both. Instead of just buying the 1 ounce coins, which I bought a few of those, I've been getting the 1/4 ounce because if some reason I needed those for trading, I don't want to give them a whole ounce. That's like worth $30. Anyway, it seems to me that that'd be something that people would still be interested in, even if it got kind of hard for trading things. Nothing beats trading goods like food, prep stuff, skills. But silver is probably the one thing that's truly called money where our paper money is more borrowed and it's depreciating really bad. So I'm not advocating to do anything really crazy and wild and really going all out. You know, I watch some prep shows or homesteading groups, and they've got pantries that are just amazing and a lot of money invested. I always, Sherry and I, normally when we go shopping, like if we go to Costco, we might buy an extra case of green beans or corn or some kind of soups, or we always keep adding every time we go out. So you'd be amazed over time, whether depending on how much time we got, but over time you have to stay within your budget, obviously. It builds up, and pretty soon you look at your pantry, you go, whoa, looking good. We did add like an extra freezer. We do have generator backups to maintain those freezers in case we had a power situation. And of course we got the weather, and depending where you guys live, you may have weather related outages, and it'd be nice to have some backups on that kind of stuff. So when it comes to prepping, getting prepared, the only thing I suggest to people is try to think ahead and keep playing the what if scenario. What if the power went out? What if I couldn't, our water stopped for a while? What if the weather made the roads unpassable? What if we get a lot of snow and we can't get out of here? How would we do? And hopefully over time you can say, hey, I'm doing better. And what if I can't get to town and buy things, but I have a community around me that maybe have things that I want? What could I trade? And then last but not least, it's not a bad idea to have a little bit of a weapon or an ammunition. Hopefully you'll never, ever, ever have to use it, but don't get caught without it. It's kind of like a Visa card, right? So anyway, those are the things I kind of wanted to yak with you about. I don't want to be considered like a prepping, totally prepping kind of guy, but I think being prepared, being a visionary, and everything we've talked about here, nothing, if nothing ever happens, which is what we want, then you got extra food. You're good for, nothing has been hurt. Rotate the things that you buy. Always prep for food that you like. Don't buy food you wouldn't eat. Well, some of the good places we found to go is there's a place called Buy Mart here, which is a really good place to buy a lot of prep food that's really good to keep in the, for long periods of time. I actually found those little canned hams, not the big ones, but the little guys. And I think you can get 2 for $5. Things like that. Another great place I heard, I haven't done it yet, is the dollar stores. Sound like a good place to get some prepping kind of things. And those are just suggestions, just kind of keeping everybody aware, keep on thinking about it. And of course, having faith really helps. I always ask myself before I do a show, Lord, please give me, let me reach one person. And hopefully I've worded something the way that person needs to hear it, and give me that gift. And I always hope that that's the case. No, I'm not a highly intellectual kind of person. I relate to probably more like rednecks. So we always hope that our videos touch one person, two, whatever it takes, that might help them be prepared, make them feel better, let them know that we're thinking about these things also. And there's no reason to panic, but it's a good idea to be prepared and be a visionary. I am so much a visionary, it's not even funny. That's why I got a wife that's just the opposite of me, thank goodness. So anyway, guys, that's all I wanted to bring up. I want to thank you very much for listening and watching our channel. Please take the time to like and subscribe and share our videos all over. We really do appreciate it. Love to hear comments. Say hello. Let us know what you're up to, what you're thinking, things you'd like us to talk about, whether it's a farm, on a homestead, how we're preparing for the winter, what's it like in Central Oregon. We don't get the harsh winters like you folks do in the East Coast or up by the Great Lakes and stuff. Wow, you guys get some serious snow, but we do get snow here. But you know, with the weather change and all that stuff going on, it could be an interesting winter. Who knows? But nothing to panic about. Just being prepared. You know, this time of year, we're worried about our equipment, making sure like our trailer is winterized. We're making sure that our cars are running good. We're making sure we have fuel for the generators, fuel for the tractor, and treated that fuel so it doesn't go bad on us. Yeah, those are the kind of things that we're doing. So anyway, I love to hear what you're doing, what you're thinking. Maybe you think, oh, this is crazy. We're not preparing at all. It is what it is. Yeah, we'd love to hear from you. So thank you very much for listening to the Rangerrob Country Living Channel. And please share our videos and hit that like button. The like button really helps us out. We do appreciate that. So guys, be safe, be ready, and be friendly. And think of others too. Anyway, guys, have a great day now. Bye. Thank you very much for watching our video. Please take the time to like, subscribe, and share our videos all over the whole wide world. Thanks.